When you're a magician, you learn there's a wizard behind the curtain all the time. You're formulating in your head how all these things are working. It's very methodical and logistical, and you're putting it all together. It kind of strips the wonder a little bit, you know? I think God knew that, you know? So my question for the Lord was, I know you are who you say you are, and I believe that you did walk the earth, and I acknowledge your truth, but I need you to make this so real to me that I cannot ignore it. Just make it really real to me. I began this really, you know, intense pain began in my leg. My leg began to swell up pretty bad, and they said it was a blood clot and just needed to get medicine, and but then the pain continued to increase. I went to the hospital and got diagnosed within the day. Like, they knew right away. Acute lymphoblastic leukemia was the initial diagnosis. My white blood cells, they were growing so rapidly, they were like a bomb went off in my body. They told me that if you don't do anything, you're gonna die in 2 months. My first thoughts again were, man, God, where are you? It'd be great if there was some protection. It'd be great if you could come in here and heal me, like, now. You know, if you are real, you gotta step into the situation and do something. You know, wrap it up in a nice big bow and send me off on my way, because I cannot do this. I had no idea what I was in for. The setup that God was getting ready to do in my life to just blow me away. It gets bigger, better, and more fabulous than any illusion you can ever see, more powerful than any music you can hear. And then they told me the worst news, which was, this is even more unique of a cancer than we initially anticipated. And like, the bad news just kept getting worse. It's called Philadelphia positive ALL, and we can't cure it with chemotherapy, but we're gonna get you into remission. But then they knew it was gonna come back at a 90% chance of relapse. And either the chemo would kill me or the cancer would kill me. It was one or the other. So they said the only way around this is if you have a bone marrow transplant to be totally well. Your whole life is hinging upon finding someone in the world whose DNA matches yours close enough so that they're willing to go through with this procedure. After a few months of chemo, they said out of those 9 million people, there's only 16 potential matches in the world that we know of that might be able to cure you of your disease. And then about a month later, there was one perfect match. It was a 10 out of 10 match. And they said, we've contacted this person, and they're willing to go through with the procedure. As they're preparing you for this, they say things like, it's really cool because on, you know, April 23rd, you're going to be like a baby inside the womb all over again, and you get a brand new birthday. You know, essentially, you're going to be born again. There's chemotherapy to treat cancer, and then there's chemotherapy to destroy your immune system. And the reason why is because they're trying to get rid of the old man. In my mind, in my worldview, made a lot of sense. They destroy you. You just don't have any control.
To go stand up, walk over to that chair and sit down, it's me. It requires all the energy in my body. I just don't have any energy. I haven't eaten anything edible like the last 4 or 5 days. But I'm feeling today is going to just be another really bad day.
The scripture that I clung to was to live is Christ, to die is gain, Philippians 1. There is this moment where they call it the first hour. They brought my wife out of the room, and they didn't tell me this, but they said, you know, this is the most sensitive time of this entire process. In this next hour, he's either gonna accept this new blood or he's gonna reject it and potentially die. And we just want you to know that. They dripped the new blood, the 1 in 9 million matched blood, into my body. And my body received it. My body received the perfect blood. I was resurrected from the dead because of the perfect match in the world that was able to be substituted on my behalf so I could live again. It's literally no longer I who live, but it's someone else who lives on the inside of me. And the life that I live by faith in the new system, the new blood, the new life that was willingly substituted on my behalf. But one thing that I don't have question about is who Jesus is and how he wants to be intimately involved in our lives. I feel like I'm Lazarus. I feel like I'm alive today because the gospel was illustrated most perfectly in my life.